Hey, good morning, everyone. Eric here from Nomadic Fanatic, coming to you from Taterland here in Sholo, Arizona, 7,000 feet. Today, they are forecasting some high winds. And what that means is, well, it's always a little windy here, but when they forecast high winds, batten down the hatches. We are gonna get some 55 mile per hour gusts today up here in the White Mountains. But today's an exciting day for me because we are finally working on the hot tub off-grid. Hey everyone, Eric here from Nomadic Fanatic. I will be uploading this video with some connected internet. Check out the video description below for how I upload all my videos high speed, on the go, off-grid internet. Making a couple changes this year with my hot tub setup. And I had said in the past that I was not going to use this as a hot tub this summer. It would be a heated pool. However, stay tuned because we're gonna try some things. I would love to be able to have an actual hot tub over 100 degrees. Completely off-grid running on solar, but there are some other options out there too. They make these propane heaters. I mean, that's an expense too, but they do have a propane option at night. In the daytime, when you're getting all this sun, you're gonna have no problem pulling 1300 watts to be able to heat the hot tub, but at night, that's when you lose most of the heat anyway. You gotta have something else going on. I was also thinking about using some power stations, so don't quote me when I said we're not going to use it for a hot tub. We might try it, but first we got to get water in this. And like I said, I've made some changes right off the bat. First one being that, anytime you're sitting in this, you don't want to just be baking out in the middle of the sun. So installing this underneath the 3000 watt solar array. Right now there's a little bit of sun coming on it right now, but the sun will be here all day and then the sun will set over there in the west. But yeah, underneath here, that way if I do mount a TV right here with an outdoor protector, if I mount a TV right there, it'll be protected and we'll be able to see it because we're not just sitting out in the sun. Now, first of all, I spent a lot more time. I actually moved the hot tub out off camera, dug this out and completely leveled this area. It is completely level, as well as I'm tired of replacing holes in these Coleman spas, so I picked up this. Actually, it was on Amazon. It's made for hot tubs. I think it's a half-inch foam that you put together, and then it makes a circle for these 77-inch hot tubs. Of course, also with the tarp, just to kind of help. And then it also has a little thing for the base here as well. But we need 277 gallons of water in here so that we can start heating. And I am very near the outlets. So over here behind the propane tank, got my 30 amp for the RV off the solar system, as well as this GFCI. We're gonna be using this GFCI, but might have to modify it because that big control thing might not fit in there. But yeah, Danny and I are gonna go pick up some water down at the Stanford General Store in the back of his truck and get this guy filled up. Hold on, it is super windy today and I have a magical microphone that saves my videos. It's gonna be a fun project. And Danny painted his water tank green to keep that algae stuff from happening, so you actually drink the water in there also. So you painted it green and then need to load it back up here, put it on the truck so we can go get water. I'm gonna do that here shortly. Also just want to mention, because if I don't mention it, everyone just gonna think I'm stupid that I didn't bring it up. No, I realize that there are other ways to heat pools and hot tubs. Like, they actually sell solar water heaters, solar. They're all gonna do the same thing essentially, but you can buy a kit if you want to that has black hoses running in circles that are painted black or in lines, and then the sun heats that up inside the black tube and then you circulate that through the pool. But to be clear, you're not gonna get 104 degrees out of that. You're gonna get something warmer than the ambient temperature. I mean, like, because last time I brought this up, someone said that you could just run hoses right here. Pew, a bunch of hoses right here, and the sun's gonna come down, and then it'll be free. It'll be free heat for your hot tub. No, it's not gonna heat a hot tub. It'll make your cold pool a little warmer. And believe me, I've already tried this. So Robert used 250 feet of dark hose up in Missouri to help keep his pool a little warmer than ambient temperature cold out there. And it was nice. It's something extra that you can add to it. Also, well, let's be clear, just like the wind, when everyone says, oh, Eric, you need wind generators out there at Taterland. No, I don't. all of my batteries are completely 100% all day with this solar system. Adding wind generators won't do anything in the daytime because we're already at 100%. What happens at night? The sun goes down, so does the wind. The wind goes down to nothing at night. It's the nighttime that we have a problem with because we're strictly running on batteries until the next day when the sun comes out. So, doing the whole hose thing in the daytime when we're already using the heater, and then at night the hose doesn't do anything. I need something at night, which is why I'm thinking that using individual power stations and depleting those power stations overnight and then going back to my solar system in the daytime, but also recharging those separate power stations in the daytime so that I can plug them back in. See, I'm trying to think of a better way to do it to save from losing 10 to 15 degrees overnight when you don't have any power, wind, solar, or anything else. So that's my dilemma here. But yeah, I am well aware of that, plus the propane or natural gas options for heating a hot tub. But then we start getting into like crazy stuff where it's like, no, I don't need all that. Let's just have a heated pool, you know? All right. Fresh water going in, pumping it from the truck right now. Oh, this is awesome. Or just use my skill saw and cut it out and make it fit. That's better because I don't like running extension cords with anything that's high wattage. So that's better now. We were just emptying the last of that 55-gallon drum, which filled it this much. But got the pump and the heater on full blast right now. Danny's gonna go fill up all three tanks. And to start, for reference, 64 degrees. That's the water temperature right now. I got the filter, got the filter and the heater on. Make sure the bubbles still work. Cool, cool, cool. And yeah, as long as you're above that first line where the filter's at, you can run the filter now. And is that warm? That is warm. Okay, let's check inside because we're pulling about 1300 watts right now on the system. Let's see here what it says. 55, and we're still at 55.4 volts on our lithium battery bank, 55.5. Pull up our little cheat sheet here for a 48 volt lithium, and we are literally at 100%. Look, 54.4. Between 58 is 100%. If it drops down under 53.6, then we're at 99%. So our batteries are floating, bringing in 395 volts out of the solar panels, and we're floating, pulling 1300 watts, which means we are absolutely 100% unlimited right now with solar and running it this on full blast. That's pretty exciting. Of course, that doesn't last all day because the sun will eventually move and then set, and then anything still plugged into the system is gonna pull directly off my 800 amp hours of lithium. So we gotta figure something out. We testing this quite a bit here. We're still at 64 degrees here, so it takes a while. All right, the SaluSpa hot tub is full up to the max. Diana got me this cool inflatable little table for tablets and cell phones and Keystone lights, maybe some nachos. I like that. I'm gonna put the top on it and we'll see. I might go in it later today. We're still at 68 degrees. So we'll see. I might go in it later today. Check out this forecast coming up. Zero rain, sunshine, 80 degrees. Yeah. That looks comfortable. In the meantime, we still got some water left over, so running the rest of it through a hose and just kind of topping off my RV while it's over here, even though I do have access to the green tank over there, but might as well top this off. Yep, and when that's good, Danny's gonna take it over to his RV, top off his RV, and we should be good. All right, got the cover put on with the insulated topper. That'll help maintain the heat. We'll let this go for maybe 3 hours or so. We'll test it out. Well, I'm caught up on my Geico insurance, but this gecko seems to want to hang out next to me, right outside the hot tub, actually. Maybe getting a little bath. Yeah, enjoying the water. Yeah, he's licking it. That's exactly what he's doing. He's like, thanks, man. It's awesome. I needed some water. All right, well, you stay out there And just leave me alone, okay? All right, you stay right there. He's a cutie. All right,
well, it's the next day, and I'm in the hot tub. Well, let's just go ahead and change it already. I'm in the heated pool. I have an update for you here. It is the next day, and currently, we're at 77 degrees. I would rather that say 80-something, but for right now, with absolutely no wind in Sholo today, it's a perfect time to get in here and have a little chat with you. Came to some realizations. It's comfortable, but like I said, I would rather it be in the 80s if it were going to be a heated pool. So yesterday, I left it on with the lid and the heater all the way until the sun went down, and then I checked the temperature, and we were actually at 81 degrees, which would have been a great time to pop in. That was 4 degrees warmer than it is right now the next day. However, then I thought, well, how long can we run this off just my lithium batteries in Babe the Blue Box? And it did not take long. And as a matter of fact, 3 hours later, at about 9:30 p.m., my lithium batteries in the shed, after pulling 1,400 watts continually and not cycling off once, were down to 17% at 9:30 p.m. I turned off the heater, left the pump on overnight, and now here back the next day, it is now 11 a.m., and I turned it back on. Well, we went from 81 degrees overnight with no heater back all the way down to 71 degrees. We lost 10 degrees with the cover on overnight and no heater. Turned it back on, and now as you see, we're back up to 77, so 6 degrees warmer in 3.5 hours since I turned it back on. And I highly suspect that that will get back up into the 80s by the end of today when I unplug it. The problem is we simply do not have the storage capacity overnight to keep this thing going. Even if I got it up to 104 degrees by the end of the day, we would lose at least 10 overnight, and then we just wouldn't be able to recover. That's why, I may have been a little ambitious and I may have hoped for a little too much. The truth is, I don't have the capacity to run this as a hot tub. It could be a warm tub, but I'm going to continue to call it a heated pool out here off-grid, a comfortable heated pool. And then later on, I do actually plan to incorporate some other DIY solar pool heaters. It'll be different than this system with this filtration. It'll be a standalone system over there. I also want to get some wind protection. And again, building something right here with a TV up there so I can sit where you guys are at and look up at a TV in the daytime in the shade underneath the solar panels, that'll be really comfortable. So for right now, again, just like last year, we have a heated pool, but it's perfect for just one person in here, and I'm comfortable, and I like this little floating dock thing that Diana got me. Fits everything I need, including the camera in my hand, so. And it doesn't get too far away from me. So yeah, all right, that's the verdict. You guys have any other ideas for me that I haven't thought about? Because really, it's just the nighttime capacity. The fact that 800 amp hours of lithium only lasted 3 hours once the sun went down is not a good sign. And I don't really have an answer to that. So, anyways, we got a heated pool. I'm happy. I'm going to be very comfortable this summer. I'll dip in here whenever I want. It'll lower my body temperature, and then I'll be able to enjoy things going on. Did I mention it's 85 degrees today here? In Sholo, 85 degrees. That's nice, and that makes this really, really comfortable. All right. Y'all have a good one. Opie and Tara, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye. All right, I'm actually going to cut back in here, guys. I hadn't planned to film anymore tonight, but as the sun is just now dipping over the edge here, I was getting ready to go turn off the heater on the pump, just like I did yesterday, and I just looked at it, and I'm a little in shock, because I didn't expect us to go from, what was it, 77 to 97 degrees. Was not expecting that. Now that is literally a hot tub off-grid. So I have just proven that you literally can run a hot tub off-grid. However, I am literally getting ready to turn off the heater right now, but let's go check one more thing inside just to see where we are at here. Turn on my inverter. It's only blinking AC, so no more charge. 51.2 volts. 51.2. Let's look at my cheat sheet. 51.2 is 17% lithium. So very, very low.
and the sun is just now setting. So
I don't know. It feels like a win and a loss. I don't think it's feasible to actually... Wait a minute. Let's put the same effects as what happened last night into effect. If I weren't going to get in it right now, which I am, I've got my robe and my beer. I'm getting ready to go in right now. But let's say we turn off the heater right now at 97. If we lost another 10 degrees overnight and started at 87 tomorrow morning at 8 a.m., at 87 instead of 73, I guarantee you that tomorrow we will be up to 104 degrees by this time tomorrow. However, I really want to go in the hot tub at 97 degrees. So I'll keep you guys updated on this, okay?
Okay.
Woo, this is hot. Oh, that is hot. Woo, that feels great.
Nice. This sucks.
What? This sucks.
Off-grid hot tub?
Oh my gosh.
It is worth having a hot tub. Hang tight. I'm actually not going to end this video yet. Gonna enjoy this for a little bit, maybe let it go down to 90%, and I think tomorrow at the same time I'll be showing you an off-grid hot tub at 104 degrees. Okay, all right, stay tuned. Bear me, thank you. All right, we'll check back in tomorrow, guys. All right, guys, checking in about 20 hours later the next day, officially 72 hours since I started attempting to heat up a hot tub off-grid, and we're gonna see what happens today. I've been running errands, I've gone to town twice for crying out loud, and just gonna wait for the sun to set and then check on the hot tub heater and find out for sure. Can you have a hot tub off-grid without power, just solar? We're gonna find out in this video. All right, about 90 minutes left of sun officially here. I'm getting ready to shut off the heater once again here on day 3 of the hot tub. Let's see if we made it. Oh my gosh, 102 degrees. We're gonna make it. We're gonna make it. Well, guys, it's not even dark out yet, but my off-grid hot tub is at 104 degrees maximum temperature, as hot as it can get, off solar alone. Got my little power station here. Some AC power. I can't see it right now. It needs to get darker. I've added some lights. Just colored lights I got at Big Lots, and I zip tied them all the way around. Once it gets dark, it'll be fantastic ambient lighting right underneath the hot tub. So anyways, I'm gonna have dinner, then we're gonna hop in my off-grid hot tub, which, it's funny because I'm still going to get 30,000 comments of everyone calling me a liar and saying it's impossible. You know, the people who didn't watch till the end, because there's, you know, oh, I never got to the... You got to watch till the end, guys, before you say anything. So, yeah, give another hour here and we'll come back to this. Well, the movie was awesome. The hot tub is hot and looking awesome. Oh my gosh. Freaking A, that's my waterproof light down there. Here, let's do it. Let's do this. Oh my gosh. You can't do it, Eric. You can't have a hot tub off-grid. It's not possible, Eric. It can't be done, Eric. Okay. It's funny because anytime somebody tells me I can't do something, whatever it is, I'm like more obliged to make it happen, to try it. Okay, it did take 3 days, but we do have a working hot tub, 104 degrees max, off-grid, with absolutely no power and no light now, too. Just completely off-grid. Love it.